SBWC Nation, this is the day that the Lord has made. We come to rejoice and be glad in it. We come to let you know how great our God is. Hallelujah. Also, congratulations to all of our 2020 graduates all over the nation, all over this community. Let God know how great He is in your lives. Tell somebody, say, how great is our God? Hallelujah. Come on, let's put a praise on our lips. Hallelujah. We make a joyful noise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. flesh that he has a name that's above all names. Sing it out, you're the name. Father, you are worthy of all praise. And our very hearts will sing. Our praise, our God. Hallelujah. Lift your hands wherever you are. Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we come to decree and declare how great you are. How good you are. How good you are to us, Lord God. God, you've been better than good, hallelujah, than we've been to ourselves, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we lift you up on this great day. Hallelujah, Lord God. God, continue to shift the atmosphere, Lord God. Continue to make ways out of no ways, Lord God. Continue to be a way maker, a promise keeper, Lord God. Continue to do the things that you do best within your people, Lord God. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, you are great. Great are you, Lord. You are mighty. Mighty are the works of your hand. And we honor you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. Let the anointing flow through our houses, Lord God. Let your spirit flow through our houses, Lord God. Let your oil, let your oil flow through our houses, Lord. Hallelujah. It's the oil that makes the difference. Oh God, and we bless your name. We bless your name today. Oh God, we pray that you enjoy this worship experience, Lord God, in your homes, Lord God. Hallelujah. We honor you and we bless you, God. Oh God, we pray for you right now through this pandemic. Oh God, that you will continue to look to the hills from which cometh your help. For you know that your help comes from the Lord. Hallelujah. We decree and declare that no sickness hits your homes. No disease hits your homes. Hallelujah. We call down this coronavirus right now in the name of Jesus. Our God is mighty. Our God is holy. Our God is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. And we honor you today. Thank you to HBWC Nation. Hallelujah. Thank you for this worship experience that we get to give to you. We bless you, and it's in Jesus' name. Amen.
Great day, HBWC Nation. Welcome to our Graduate Sunday. It's Virtual Sunday, guys. It's our Graduate Sunday, and I'm so excited that you're joining us today. Praise team was awesome. Worship was good. But I want to spend time, guys, and just celebrate our graduates around the world for a brief moment. I'm trying not to be long, but get your friend, get your family, bring them to the page, and let's celebrate God together and worship him and honor our grads today in a really mighty, mighty way. So let's pray real quick. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this time and opportunity to bless you, God, as we come to the table and eat, Father God. We thank you now for the opportunity to worship in Jesus' name. Amen. Again, welcome to all you guys around the world. We want to celebrate our grads right now. Facebook Nation, HBWC Nation, right now. Let's go ahead and give a huge shout out, wave, celebrate for our grads. Get on our page right now and shout out your school, your city, that child you know, whether it's pre-K, elementary, middle school, going to high school, our high school seniors, or our collegiate at the collegiate level. We celebrate you. We honor you this year. I know 2020 was different, but God is still on your side, guys. In our own church right now, we celebrate our grads this year, especially our high school senior, Cross Jackson. We give you a shout out. Jay Noel, we give you a shout out. Miss Drains, we give you a shout out. And then Charity Poole, we give you a shout out. And Brooke Walker, we give you guys a huge shout out on your accomplishment going to the next level. Now, as we celebrate 2020, I want to jump into the word today that's going to really help all of us. All of us, because here to tell you right now, even though we're celebrating our 2020 graduates, I want everybody to take an opportunity to just whoosh out for a minute. All of us have been affected by this coronavirus in some kind of way, and all of us just living in 2020, all of us will remember 2020. But let me tell you something. This message is for all of us. All of us are graduating. All of us, as we celebrate our graduates, this message is for all of us around the world. So look at this text right here in Matthew 3. Why not use Jesus Christ as an example of what I'm talking about today as we honor and celebrate our 2020 graduates and also celebrate you for living during this time. Matthew 3:16 and 17 reads, after Jesus was baptized, he immediately came up from the water. Suddenly, the heavens were open, and he saw the Spirit of God coming down as a dove to him. Look at verse 17. Then a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved Son. This is my Son, whom I love. Listen, whom I love, my Son, whom I am pleased. Listen, I want to tell you guys real quick. This is what I call a redefining moment. What should I talk about? A redefining moment. Because life will try to define you. Life will try to define me. Now, I understand there's nothing wrong with being saved and my salvation being defined by that. But when life comes from the left, life comes from the right, and the plan God has for my life, if I'm not careful, life will try to define me. You know, my bad habits will try to define me. The things I struggle with will try to define me. Our kids coming out of school this year, whether it's elementary, middle school, high school, collegiate, if you're not careful, we're not careful, we'll think what's going on is defining us. I don't want life shouldn't have to define me. And I understand I come out of my home, a great mom, and I love what I did, but I didn't have a father. If I'm not careful, me not having a father will define me. If you don't have your regular graduation like they say you would or should, it will define you. It will be a place where you can remember and say, man, if that wouldn't have happened, I wouldn't have did this. If I hadn't have went to jail, I wouldn't have done that. I want to get to a place where I don't want what life does to me to define me. I want to redefine it. I want to redefine the moment. I want you guys right now not to capitulate down to what life have offered all of us. 2020 grad, this is your moment. This is your year. Mom, dad, living right now in 2020, this is your year. You said, Pastor, I lost my job. Don't let it define you. You redefine it. This can be your opportunity to think bigger. This could be your opportunity to dream higher. This could be your opportunity to reassess what God really has for you. Don't let this moment, how about say about define you or define us to think that we can't become what God has called us to be. So let me show you something. I read a book one time by a great, he's dead now, but he was a great, he was a president of Morehouse College for a while, and he was a dean of Howard University, and he wrote a book called The Born Rebel. You know what I'm talking about, those who read a lot, by name Benjamin May. His name was Benjamin May. He was called Born Rebel. He was born as a sharecropper, a slave, and yet God brought him through the ranks, and he did not allow that position or the slave to define him, but yet he redefined it. But he had a good quote. He said, child must learn early to believe that she is somebody worthwhile and that she can do many praiseworthy things. I'm going to read that again. A child must learn early to believe that she, listen, is somebody or he is somebody worthwhile, and that she or he can do many praiseworthy things. If right there alone, if someone speaks life to you early, they can define you. That's good stuff. But if you're not careful, life will come along and try to define you something you shouldn't be. And if you're not careful, this coronavirus, this COVID-19, was trying to define our students coming out of high school, coming out of college, didn't have an opportunity to walk down the aisle or whatever. They're trying to put things together now that our kids can graduate and walk down the aisle and get their diploma. And I'm excited about that. But I don't want this moment to define them. When I want them to take an opportunity to redefine the moment. This is the moment where my game changed. This is the moment where I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. This is the moment where I decided to change careers and go another path. Bible said in Jeremiah 29:11, I love how it reads. He said, I know the thought, or I know the plan that I have for you, declare the Lord. Plans for welfare and not calamity, to give you a future and a hope. Man, I want you to really grab that text real quick. Because look at me. These guys were in a hard place, a bad place. And if you're not careful, that place that they're in would define them. So look, God Almighty used Jeremiah and spoke to Jeremiah and said, I know the thought and the plan I have for you. I know it's rough. I know it's tough. But don't let that situation define you. Let the word I speak to you redefine that situation. And I'm telling you, God's saying, child of God, God is saying, student, I have a plan for you. Look at that text. I have a plan for you. But let's go look at Jesus Christ as we did, as he tried to come to a place and redefine a moment. What you go? Let's look at this text. I love the Bible. It speaks to our modernity right now. Right now, there are people around the world who are going through a hard time, dealing with stuff. We're speaking to our grass right now. I'm talking to my grass, I know, but all of us can fit in this text. The Bible said in Matthew 3:1, let's walk this text real quick, give you a bite drop. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the desert of Judea. Verse 2 said, and saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near. What is John the Baptist doing? John the Baptist is in a moment. He's in a moment where he's bringing attention to people's sin. And John the Baptist is a forerunner for Jesus Christ. So he's out front. Now, Jesus is also born, but Jesus have not yet stepped on the scene. John understand what his purpose was. His purpose was to come out, speak, and say, repent. Hear what God is saying. Hear what he's saying. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near. He's not here yet, but repent because he's on the way. So John is a forerunner for Jesus Christ. So back then, before Jesus came, John was baptizing. And as if you repent, John said, baptize to be cleansed of your sin. That's the moment. But look what happened in verse 11. It goes to the text. He said, people came to see John. John said, I baptize you with water, so that you will change the way you think and act. But the one who comes after me is more powerful than I. He said, I am not worthy to remove his sandal. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. John was in a moment, and he knew in his spirit that even though I am in this moment is not gonna define me. Look what John said. John says, somebody is coming behind me. And here's what he's gonna do. He's gonna come so strong that he will baptize you with Holy Ghost and fire. He's gonna give you an anointing so strong that's gonna shake the earth. He's gonna put an anointing on you. He's gonna have an anointing so powerful that even when moments come like they are right now, they won't burn you up. He said, the Bible said that he's gonna come and he's gonna give you something powerful, baptize you with Holy Spirit and with fire. But now look at here, look at the text in verse 12. He said, he's going to clean house. He said, look at here now, when he comes, he's gonna clean house, make a clean sweep of your life. He'll place everything true in its proper place before God. Everything false, he'll put out with the trash to be burned. Look what Jesus is doing. He's telling us Jesus is coming. But when he comes, he's not gonna allow the moment to define him. Jesus already knew who he was. He said Jesus already would know who he is. So when he comes, he's coming to clean house. He's coming to pull stuff out of you because life have tried to define you. Life have tried to define me. And so if my life is going to be redefined, I first have to have Jesus in my heart to have a true definition of who I am. My God is I. If my life is going to be redefined, my life must first be defined about who Jesus Christ is in my life. I can start right there and go to preaching and run around this stadium, but I won't do that because God is, Pastor. What's my message right now? Let me slow down because I want to breathe for a minute because I'm feeling really good about this message because I want to speak to you about not allowing the moment we're in right now to define us, but we're going to redefine it because what Christ has done in our life. Let's go to verse 11, the next verse. It says, then Jesus appeared. He shows up. He came from Galilee to Jordan, the river to be baptized by John. He came to the Jordan. The man John is talking about has arrived. He has arrived in a moment. He's arriving in a moment. Now, remember what John preached. John said that to be forgiven of your sin, repent, you must be baptized. Other word, that means to be dipped in water. That's the church sacrament. That's what we do as a church. We dip. Now, I know when we go back to dipping, how we're going to do that when we come out of church. But back then, to have forgiveness of sin, you had to be dipped in the water and repent before Jesus came. But now Jesus steps on the scene, and look what he does. John tries to stop. The Bible said Jesus appeared and wanted to be baptized. But look at the next verse. The Bible said, but John tried to stop him and said, I need to be baptized by you. Why are you coming to me to be baptized? Because Jesus says, before I can redefine a moment, I said, "Ko ba 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 ba." I gotta be in the moment. Before I can redefine your life, I gotta be in your life. Before I can change your marriage, I gotta be in your marriage. Before I can change that drug habit, I gotta be in you. Before I can change your sexual identity, I gotta first be in you and with you. Before I can change your business strategies, I have to be in you. So before I can redefine a moment, I gotta be in the moment. If you want God to redefine what you got going on, let him come to the moment. If before God can redefine anything at my church, anything that's going on, he first has to be in the moment. Pastor, as you pray to go back to church, stop hearing what folks saying on Facebook. Stop jockeying for attention. Let God be in the moment and let him redefine the moment. He will give us Holy Spirit, tell us what to do. Your church is not like my church. You do what God tells you to do. I do what God tells me to do, but he first has to be invited to the moment, to redefine the moment. So Jesus jumped in and said, no, your moment says I must be baptized. John, your moment says I must be baptized because I'm in your moment. So I'm coming to be part of your moment. And so John, the Bible said, he goes on in verse 15, Jesus said to him, this is the way it has to be now. This is the proper way to do everything that God required of us in this moment. Then John capitulated. He gave in to what Jesus said. Jesus said, listen, I want to be in your relationship. I got to first get in. Let me in the door of your life. Let me in the room of your thoughts. Don't sit in that room by yourself. Mr. Banker, don't sit there by yourself. Mr. Governor, let me in. You got all these folks around you, but let me in. Mr. President, you got all these folks around you, but let me in. Let me in the moment. I'm going to obey your laws. Let me in your moment. Let me in your room. Let me in your space. Let me in that place where you put guidelines at. Let me in that moment. Jesus come and submit and capitulate to the moment. In verse 16, it says, after Jesus was baptized. I love this. He was baptized. After he became part of the moment, Jesus allowed himself to become part of the moment. Look at the text. He said, after Jesus was baptized, he came up from the water. Suddenly, heavens were open, and he saw the Spirit of God coming down like a dove. Jesus was part of the moment. I'm asking God, be a part of what we got going on right now. Be a part of our moment. Be a part of our moment. The Bible said he came and was a part of the moment. He came to be a part of the moment. And once he came part of the moment, the Bible said, suddenly heaven got open. And he saw, John saw, the Spirit of God coming down as a dove on him. Once Jesus become part of your moment, look what happened. Holy Spirit had room to work. And now what he does, Jesus said, oh, the only way I can redefine your moment is be a part of your moment. Ooh. The only way Jesus can redefine your moment, I got to say this again, he has to be a part of our moment. The only way Jesus can heal us, he first has to be bruised for us. Yeah, come on. The only way Jesus can carry our burden, he has to be the burden. The only way Jesus, say, come on. The only way Jesus can get me out of debt, he first has to become my debt. The Bible said he was bruised for my iniquity. The chastisement of my peace was on him. And by his stripes, we are healed. So the only way God can become my peace, yeah, come on, he got to be in my peace. The only way he can get it, he got to be in the moment. The only way he can get us out of this debt he got to become my debt. And that's what John did. He said, I came to be in the moment, because before that John, I was in the moment. I was baptized. I was in the moment. But the Bible said once he got in the moment, he redefined the moment. This moment won't define me. I'm refining the moment. I am refining the moment. Jesus was not a sinner. John was only baptizing. Look at the text. John was baptizing because those who had sinned. He said, repent. Repent before the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Therefore, the only way to get saved, you had to repent and be baptized. Repent, be baptized. Jesus had not sinned. So why would Jesus be baptized? So what I'm saying about Jesus had never sinned before in his life. And but Jesus had to be baptized. You're asking myself, I've never missed school a day in my life. Why I gotta miss school now? I've never been sick a day in my life. Now I got this going on. Jesus has never had sinned a day in his life. So Facebook Nation, why would Jesus have to be baptized if he had never sinned? Because the only way he can redefine a moment, he got to come be part of your moment to erase the moment. Let me say it again real slow. The only way he can redefine a moment, he got to be a part of the moment, Shekobo, to abolish the moment. Because here's what's happening. Once Jesus got baptized and once the Holy Spirit opened up, Jesus said, I am going to redefine baptism. I am redefining what John said baptism was. And verse 17 said, a voice from heaven said, this is my son in whom I love, my son in whom I'm well pleased. Jesus came in the moment, redefined baptism. He redefined the moment. Don't let this, what we're going through, dealing with, define you. Baby, I'm declaring right now, it's going to redefine you. Other words, Pastor, what you mean? Baptism, when it came along, its only purpose was that you must repent, and because the kingdom of heaven was at hand. The same moment, Jesus came to that moment and redefined it. He said, here I, Jesus now saying, he said, be saved, believe in Jesus Christ, and then be baptized. Therefore, I don't have to be baptized to be saved. I believe in him. I believe in him, and I'm saved. And because I'm saved, I will be baptized. Uh-oh, we're just now saying, Pastor, that means baptism. Uh-oh, I got to stop right now. Let me come close to you right now, your kitchen roll. Let me tell you what baptism really is. And let me tell you what it really is. Baptism in itself, what I see baptism as right now. Now, I know I get baptized because I believe in Jesus Christ. Therefore, I take on the replica or example of going in underwater, coming back out. It's a picture of what Jesus did in my heart. But let me tell you what it really means to me, based on theological construct. When Jesus got baptized, God said, this is my beloved son, in whom I'm well pleased. When he did that, God defined his purpose. Look what that text said. When he did that, people of God. So in essence, now what baptism should be, baptism should be birthing you out into something. That's right. Baptism now where it was actually making you forgive you for your sin. Jesus came along and redefined it and showed me something different. He showed me the fact that now when he got baptized, God said, Holy Spirit got on him like a dove. And the Bible says that he says that this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. So now when I get baptized, God redefined the moment for me. So when I got baptized, I now ask God, what is my purpose now? How do I deal with this now? What's your plan for my life? You said in your word, you know the thought, the plan you have for my life. In spite of the moment, God spoke that word out and said, I know the thought, the plan I have for you, child of God. Let me tell you right now, if God can't be in your moment, he can't redefine your moment. I want to invite you into the table right now, all grads around the world. Now, I'm not just talking about collegiate, high school, middle school. Everybody that's living right now is a grad. This is all our graduation. all of us is about to graduate from this corona. Shit, COVID, bye, bye, bye. We're about to graduate from COVID-19. And but COVID-19 will not define us. But God said, come on, we're going to redefine it. We're going to start saying stuff like, oh, this, during this time, I saved more money. During this time, my marriage got better. During this time, my body got healed. During this time, oh, God, I'm going to redefine that moment. I'm going to speak out what God is saying about me. But that cannot happen if he's not in your moment. So I want to take a time right now and invite you to let him come to your moment. Wherever you are right now, if you're in the prison wall, wherever you are right now, sick room, wherever you are right now, I don't know where you are right in your construct, but wherever you're watching me at right now, I need you to invite him to your moment. Oh, come on, don't push him away right now. Invite him to your moment that he may redefine who God has called you to be. Accept him into your heart. Say, Lord Jesus, I receive you today. I don't care where you're at, in Nigeria, Australia, China. I'm speaking to you. Receive God today in your heart. It's time for your ceremony. It's time for your ceremony. It's time. Hit the music. Graduation music means you ended one thing and you're beginning something else. It's your rite of passage into something else. So today is your graduation. Come on. You're coming out of sin and going into the light. You're coming out of darkness and going into the right place. I'm calling you today. Come on home. Receive him as your Lord and Savior. It is your redefining moment, but he first has to come in your moment. If you let him into your heart today, say right now, I'm allowing him into my moment. Just say, my moment. And I know you're now part of us. HPWC Nation, if they say in my moment, celebrate with them. Let's celebrate them. Let them know that they're part of our family. They have been redefined. Don't let that last marriage define you. Don't let that last breakup define you. Don't let what happened or what they're saying on TV define you. Allow Jesus Christ to redefine your life. I'm so excited today about you guys. I got to stop this message because I'm excited what God is doing in the earth. How he's redefining our ministry, our giving, how we love God, love people. He's redefining our church. And I'm so excited. You're a part of our family now. If you want to be a part of our people are joining us online, you can still text to join, all that stuff. Get in the game. God is redefining the church. And I'm so excited that God is taking the church to a whole other place. So join the ride. People of God, I want to give you an opportunity to give now. Before you do, people, let me thank you real quick. Man, this week, we gave out tennis shoes. It was a campaign we tied in with our local middle elementary school, and the devil thought he was going to mess us up. But let me tell you something, people of God. We were able, because of how you give, how you sow your seed, 89 kids were blessed. I'm talking about a local elementary school, and I'm not talking about a high-end elementary school. I'm talking about a school that need our help. We were able to bless these kids. Every child got a brand new sneaker. That's a blessing called how you give. And then we turned around and gave about 100 bags of groceries to families in our community. Because of how you give, I want to challenge you right now. Don't stop your giving. Your seed is going on good ground. I want to challenge you right now. If you're out of work, I'm not talking to you. But we got to still put your seed to work. I love you and I thank you how you give. So right now on our page, Cash Out, Text to Give, Push Pay, Mail In, however you choose, I want to say give and thank you for your seed. Now I want to bless it real quick. Father God, right now, bless every person who chooses to be a part of this ministry, whether through giving or just joining the church. God, I speak blessing over their seed. I speak healing over those people, Lord God, who need our prayer, those who are dealing with cancer, COVID-19. I'm asking God that their seed today be a redefining moment. I'm praying to God right now that as you give, whether you give $5, $10, $20, $1,000, $10,000 a day, that God will redefine your seed. I speak blessings over you. I love you and thank you guys so much. HBCU Nation, again, we celebrate our grad. If you did anything this year, finished school, GED, high school, whatever level you did it at, we celebrate you right now and we love you so much. Thank you for being a part of HBWC Nation. It's a hard time for a lot of people, but we thank God we get the opportunity to come on the air and work with you and walk in faith with you. We love you guys and we'll see you next time.